The coronavirus pandemic has changed our world. Lockdowns have been imposed all over the world. Customers have not been able just to go outside and do some shopping. This has resulted in the increase of e-commerce and the decrease of cash usage. We had seen the enforcing of all sorts of digital and cashless way of payments. Right now, more than ever, as a financial industry, we need to stay vigilant if we are to ensure our systems. Today, we are together with Thomas Feld, and we will have some questions on the managing risk pillar.
Thank you, Adriana, and thank you for having me here. I'm part of the corporate bank's cash management product organization, looking after cross-product governance topics, so essentially facilitating the development of client solutions in a safe and sound manner. I've been with the bank for 10 years and spent a large portion of it in the finance, risk and regulatory area. And I had the unique opportunity to join Deutsche Bank's One Bank Leadership Program, putting me on an 18-month journey of management trainings as well as assignments in front office as well as control functions, giving me a truly 360 view on Deutsche Bank.
Thomas, the McKinsey 2020 report observed an expected reduce in the uses of cash as a consequence of the pandemic. Moreover, they predicted by 2020, by the end, that there's going to be a 4 to 5 percentage points decrease in the global share of payments executed via cash. This is a big decrease if you compare it with the last years. This, together with first, the changes in client behavior and the fact that there are new payment solutions in the market, mostly being offered by new market participants, we see that there is a lot of noise and there is a lot of momentum at the moment. How would you say that a financial institution can have an active participation in all these changes and developments?
As you rightly say, new market participants and new payment methods resulted actually in an increased complexity in the payment domain and as a result, increased risk levels. So managing risk becomes a fundamental aspect. It is actually a business enabler. So financial institutions that like to tap into or enlarge their presence on those revenue pools that are opening up need to be in the position to truly understand their clients' business models and on the back of it, identify the risks and to put down the respective controls. I see there in total three aspects that are really key for success here. First of all, an agile and cross-functional setup consisting of experts from the product domain, from product governance, from the control efforts and AFC, all with strong market and product knowledge. Secondly, a good client evaluation framework that considers the client's business models and also has the right governance and due diligence structures in place. And thirdly, also the aspect around transaction surveillance. So here we need fine-geared business risk controls to have a sustainable setup in place.
So we are talking about being more agile in the way we react and how we actually recognize the business model of our clients. I do also see that clients not just expect us to have a system robustness and that our systems are secure. They also expect that we keep evolving our systems because the world is full of any kinds of risk. And moreover, right now we see the increasement of cyber risk. The World Economic Forum in 2020 set cyber attacks to critical infrastructures into the top five. If we consider this, together with the more usage of real-time payments, and by this leverage the open banking, transaction surveillance becomes key for the provision of our services. In your view, what should we focus on in the next 4 to 5 years if we want to improve specifically transaction surveillance?
I think, first of all, we need to recognize, and all financial institutions need to recognize, that the payment domain has changed. And I think, especially for transaction surveillance, it's also worth considering that large parts of the transaction surveillance landscape are regulatory driven rather than a competitive edge. However, I think it can become a competitive advantage for those that understand the changes in environment, the changes in client needs, and find the right answers and the right risk controls for these to make a difference. And I would even say that one of the enablers is to have dedicated capacity for strategy and R&D, so allowing not just to create roadmaps to show that journey, but also to assess new technologies in a way that not just focus on the potential they have, but also the limitations, and include that in the transaction surveillance landscape going forward.
Okay, this is interesting because you do see some potential for a competitive advantage in transaction surveillance. But would you also see some room for collaboration industry-wise?
Well, I think all financial institutions have an inherent interest in secure and safe financial markets, and hence a motivation to combat misuse or any threats that are posed by bad actors. So I think collaboration among financial institutes is a key, right? Yeah. And we already do that in the industry on different occasions and in different forms and shapes. But I really think if we can intensify that, do even more collaboration and co-creation in that field, then the financial industry will surely look very different in a couple of years from now.
I totally agree with you. As an industry, we had seen in the past that we achieve more when we do it together. We achieve faster, we achieve more efficiently as well. Thomas, thank you. There are many unknown risks in the market, and we are living in a geopolitical instability scene together with the increase of protectionism. Data collaboration and data analytics are going to be key for the provision of our services. Moreover, we must ensure that all market participants can provide a safeness environment in their systems for their clients. New technologies are here, the change has been accelerated, and we must embrace this while investing further in managing risk. To all of you, thank you. It's Sibos Day 4. This has been a great experience. Thank you all again for taking your time and watching the videos. Thank you, Thomas, for coming today. And for the last time, please do not forget to visit Deutsche Bank Festival of Finance, where you will find more content. Thank you.